Good morning dear students, welcome to the class. So today I'm making this video for the clarification of exercise 10.3. So we will discuss how we can solve the questions. So first question in the book, according to the book, it is given that fill in the blanks, and in that the first question is given, if 1, 2, 3 and x are in proportion, then x is equal to what? Here blank is given. Then how we can find out that what will be in the blanks? So what we have to do, how we can solve this question? So first you see here, 1, 2, 3, 4 digit is given. 1, 2, 3 and x is given. Then what we have to do? First you see here that we can write here, 1 is 2 is 3. Or here we can write here proportion, or we can write 3 ratio x. Like this we can write. And now this one we can write again, that this one we can write here 1 by 2 then is equal to 3 by x we can write here. And we have studied the relation here b to c and a to x. So in this manner we have to do here cross multiplication. Then we can write here 1 and x is equal to 2, 3 is 6. It means the value of x is 6. Then it means here x is equal to what? Here we have to write 6. Okay, so like this we can find out that what will be the value of x. So here, not to worry that if the question is given a little twist, then we have to think, then we have to solve. So like this we can solve. So here first only I have considered that what ratio we can write. So you have to know how we can create the ratio. So here we have written the ratio, then we have solved according to the method, whatever method we have studied in the previous classes. Okay, so next question it is given. Next question we will see that in next question, question is given, if 3a is equal to 5b, then a ratio b is equal to what? So blank is given here. So here it's very easy that how we can fill in the blanks by solving this question. So here nothing is given to solve a solution, but we have to think that how we can solve. So first here it is given here 3a and 5b is given. Then first what we have to do, we have to find out the LCM of 3 and 5. So when we will find out the LCM of 3 and 5, then we will find that 3 into 5 is equal to 15. Now we will divide this 15 by the 3 and 5. So if we divide by 3 the 15, then how much it will come? 3 5 is 15 and 5 3 is 15. 5 3 is 15, then 3. So like this it is come in the place of A and in the place of B. So here we can write 5 ratio 3. As A and B is given, the same as we have to A in the place of A, here 5 is given, and in the place of B here 3 is given. Like this we can find out. Okay. The next question it is given that if 3 number you see, the fill in the blanks 3 number you see, if x ratio y is equal to 4 by 4 ratio 5, and then the y ratio z is equal to 2 ratio 3. Then an x ratio 2 is equal to what? In the blanks it is given. So I am not going to write the question because our question is so low. So I am going to solve this question. So ratio is given here, x ratio y. And another ratio is given, y ratio z is given. Okay. So in the place of x and y, it is given that 4 ratio 5, and another in the place of y ratio z, there is given 2 ratio 3 is given. Like this it is given. Now what we have to see, that here this y is common. It means this ratio is according to the a ratio, b ratio, c like this it is given. So what we have to do, according to this method, we have to solve this question. Then what we have to do here, so we can say here, we can write this one, 4 ratio 5 and here 2 ratio 3. So here we think that V should be common. Okay, V should be common for both sides. Here according to the Y is given, it means both the sides it will be equal. So to make the equal, what we have to do? We have to multiply here A ratio 5, we have to multiply with 2, then it will come 10, then here what number you multiply in 2, then here it will come 10. So that we have to think, then here 2 ratio 3, if you multiply by 5, then it will come both same, then 2, 4 is 8 and 2, 5 is 10. Then here 5, 2 is 10 and 5, 3 is 15, like this number it came. So here both the number is same. So here we can write that this is common. So we can write here according to the A, B or C. So we can write this one, 8 ratio, 10 ratio, 15 we can write. But in the question it is asking what? It is asking X and Z. So what will be the X and Z? So here in the place of X and it is in the place of Z. So in the blanks we can write 8 ratio 15. This will be our answer in the fill in the blanks. Okay. So like this we can find out. But just we have to only understand that how twist question is twisting the question. According to that we have to solve the question. Next we have to say, next question, 4 number it is written, that in the 4 number you see, if 4 ratio 5 is x ratio 45, then x is equal to what? So here question is asking x is equal to what, then we have to find out the value of X. So here how we can solve this question? So we have to write this one, we can write this question that 4 ratio 5 and or is equal to, we can write 4 into 45, then we can write as 4 by 5 is equal to X by 45, we can write, yes or no, we can write this one. And now here it is in the form of A B C D, means this relation, that A relation with D and B relation with C. So here it is, then it means here we have to do the cross multiplication, then here it will come that 5x is equal to 4 into 45, then x is equal to 5 will go down, then 4 into 45 by 5, then 5 1 is 5, 5 9 is 45, then x is equal to what, 4 9 is 36, then x is equal to 36. So here x is equal to 36 we will put. So like this we can find out the answer. Okay, so whenever you will find like this, so you have whatever method we have studied in the previous examples, that we have to see now how to follow in the questions, so we can easily solve the questions. Okay, the next we have to see, next last fifth number, fill in the blanks, fifth number is given. That question is given, ratio of 2 meter, so not meter, it is centimeter, and 10 mm is, then here given the blanks. Then what will be the in the percentage, that we have to find out. So in the ratio of 2 centimeter and 10 mm is given, so we have to change. When I already told you that whenever the difference units are given, we have to make the same units. So here centimeter is given, then 2 centimeter is equal to 2 into 100, then it will come 200 mm. So we change this centimeter into the mm. Now we can write this number as 200 mm ratio 10 mm we can write, and now we can write also 200 by 10 also we can write. Okay, now what we have to do, we can find out what is the HC of 210. So here 210 HCF is 10. So we'll divide both the number by the 10. So what number will get? 10, 20 by 1. Okay, so here 20 by 1 number we have got. So here we know that after the below the any number we don't we not write the 1. So we can write here it is equal to 20. So it means that it is 20%, because it is the ratio is asking, then we have solved these questions, then it will come 20%. So like this we can write, we can solve this question. So first we have to be in our mind that we have to change the, if different unit is given, we have to change in the same units. Okay. Next. Next question, we have to see that true or false question is given. True or false, how can we can solve that? Two number, choose the true or false. So first question is given that first question is given that 4, 6, 9 are in proportion. 4, 6, 9 are in proportion. So we have to check whether it is true or false. So then how we can solve? First we have to solve this question. So this question is given in the best of A, B and C. This method we have seen previously in the example. So this question is based on this method. So here, that whenever we were solving, that time we was doing that A ratio B, then proportion, then B ratio C, like this we were writing. So here the number also we have to arrange according to this. So here 4 ratio 6, then proportion 6 ratio 9 we can write. This question like this we can arrange. And now this number we can write 4 by 6 is equal to 6 by 9 we can write. And now we have to consider 2, 3 is 6 and 2, 2 is 4. 3, 3 is 9 or 3, 2 is 6. So both here 2 by 3 and this side also 2 by 3. It means this number is proportion. So we can write here it is true. Okay, so like this we can check that whether 4, 6, 9 are in proportion or not. So it is in proportion because both the number, both the here AB and BC are equal. Next question we will see that question is given the ratio of 3 ratio 5 is the same as the ratio 5 by 3. It means here it is saying that 3 ratio 5 is given and this side given 3 by 5 ratio 3. So it is asking whether both the number are same or not. This ratio are equal or not. So here it very easy we can understand that if you write 3 by 5 and 5 by 3 if you write, then these both are not equal. These both are not equal. So this statement that ratio 3 ratio 5 is the same as the ratio 5 by 3 is wrong, because here both the number are not same. So according to writing by the in the fraction we can see that both are not same. So this is false. This statement is false. It is not correct. Like this we can find out. The next question will see 3 number is given in the choose the correct option 3 number we have to see. That question is given if raise 30 is divided. 30 raise 30 is divided in 2 parts. That in the ratio of 1 by 1 ratio 2. This 30 rupees we have to divide it in the ratio of 1 by 1 ratio 2. Then it is saying that agar if we are dividing, then the largest number will be, it is saying 18. So we have to check whether if we will divide this 30 rupees in the ratio of 1:1, then the largest number 18 will come or not. If 18 will come, it means it is correct. If not, then it will not correct. So how we can check? So we can write here, given ratio, is equal to 1:2. Okay. And what it is saying? It is saying that we have to check. Then let the number be x. So here it is given here. Then this number will consider x, because if you multiply x and 1, then it will come x. And second number we have to consider, that is 2x. Okay. Then here we can write that this we have considered, that x plus, because 2 is divided here, then we can write here x plus 2x is equal to 30, because it is saying that two part we have divided. Suppose we have supposed that x and 2 is two number, and this 30 is divided in both this number. So here 2x and x will add, then it will come 3x is equal to 30. Then x is equal to 30/3. Then 3 1 3 and 3 10 13. Then x is equal to 10. Now x is equal to 10, which is first number. First number is equal to 10, and the second number is equal to 2, and x the value of x is equal to 10. Then it will come 20. It is not coming 80, because it was saying the largest number will be 18. But here it is coming 20. It means this statement, the 3 number statement, is wrong. So we can write it is false. The next we have to see, fourth number we will see what a statement is given in the fourth number. Fourth number, it is saying that ratio of 44 paise to 1 rupee is 44:1. So here it is saying, fourth number you see, that ratio of 44 paise to 1 rupee, 44 paise to 1 rupee is 44:1. So it is saying that the 44 paise and 1 rupee, that ratio we can write 44:1, whether it is true or false. Then we have to check this one, how it will be true or false. So here first we have to, this is paise and this is rupee. So this rupee we have to change in the paise. Then 1 rupee, rupees 1 is equal to 100 paise. So we can write here 44:100 we can write, and this also we can write 44/100. Now if we will cut this number, okay, this side we can write here, it is given here 44:1. Okay, 44:1. It is saying that this 1 rupees and 44 paise and 1 rupees is equal to this ratio. So we will check here 11. And here so we will cut this number, then 44 and 100, it is given like this. Then what we have to do here, this number we have to cut. Then 2 2 4, 2 2 4, and 2 5 10, and 2 5 10, 2 5 10 and 0. Then 2 1 2, and 2 2 4, and 2 5 10. It is coming 11/25. It means the 1 rupees and 44 पैसे एंड 1 रुपीस इज इक्वल टू कमिंग द रेशियो इज कमिंग 11/20 और वी कैन राइट 11:25 बट इट इज हियर इट इज गिवन 44:44:1 इट मींस दैट व्हाटएवर रेशियो इज गिवन अकॉर्डिंग टू द 44 पैसे एंड 1 रुपी दैट इज रॉन्ग रियल रेशियो इज कमिंग 11:25 ओके सो दिस स्टेटमेंट आल्सो फॉल्स दिस नॉट करेक्ट Next, we have to see 5 number. We have already completed 5 number. It was 4 number. So, 5 number we have to see. What 5 number is given? 3 numbers. Okay, first I have this board. Then we can see the next. It is saying that 3 numbers, 36. 3 number 36, 90 and 225. 225 are in proportion. It is saying that this number in the question number 5, choose the correct true or false. That question number 5, it is saying that 36, 90 and 225 are proportion or not. So we have to check. So it is also in the form of A ratio B ratio C. So we have learnt that the A ratio B proportion, B ratio C, this method we have seen in the previous classes. So according to this, we can write here 36 ratio 90 proportion 90 ratio 225 we can write. Okay, then what we have to do, we can also write this one 36/90 is equal to 90/225 like this we can write. So here what we have to see that the HCF of 36 and 90 HCF of 36 and 90 is 18. Okay, and this side we will see that's 90/225. This the HCF of 90 and 225 is 45. Okay, so we'll divide both this number, then 18 to the 36 and 18. 5 ja 90 same as here 42 2 ja 90 and 45 5 ja 225 it means both sides it is coming equal it means that in the this number we can write 2 ratio 5 and proportion 2 ratio 5 it means that given statement is true given step 5 number statement is true so like this we can find out whether it is correct or not okay so next we have to see 2 number we have completed now we have to see the 3 number in the 3 number it is saying that convert each of the following 3 number you can see in the book also convert each of the following in the simplest form so we have to change the in the simplest form so first question is given 253 ratio 495 is given this ratio we have to change in the simplest form means the lowest form we have to change this one so how we can write so we can write this number as 253/495 then the HCF of here we can write HCF of 253 and 495 is 11 So both the number we have to divide with the 11. Then when we'll divide this number, it will come 23/71. So, 45 it will come. So this is the simplest form of 253 ratio 495. So this number we can write 23:45. This is our answer. So like this we can change in the simplest form. One more question is given there. In the second number we will see of the 3 that it is given here 2352 ratio 7952 is given. So this number we can write as 2352 divided by 7952 Now the HCF of this number we have to find out. So HCF of this number is 112. So both the number we will divide 112. So whenever we will divide this number, it will come. If you multiply 21 times 112, then it will come 2352. And this number, this 122, if you multiply 71 times, then it will come 7952. So this is our lowest term. So this number we can write 21:7. So this is our answer. Okay. So in this video, this much we will discuss. And next rest of the question we will discuss in the next video. Till take care. Bye bye. Thank you.